This is an important amendment. The amendment to the bill, if approved, would continue the millionaire's surcharge for the next calendar year, with two exceptions. It would then be only for people making $1 million or more. Despite what some of my colleagues on the other side said we were interested in, only people making $200,000. This would only be for people making $1 million or more, and the second change would be 30% of the revenue would go to an educational assistance fund, which would only be used for the payment of education aid to school districts and BOCES. You know, we took a very important act when we balanced the budget to cap a $10 billion budget deficit. But we did that with a lot of pain to a lot of people in the state of New York, especially those people who are least able to afford the high taxes in this state, and we are the second highest paid taxes, the second highest state in the country, only to New Jersey. We need to have the people who are the wealthiest in our society pay a little bit more so we can restore some of these services. We've had discussions over and over again. We've had discussions tonight. I remember some of the comments from our colleagues about the MTA payroll tax. And there was a comment from the other side of the aisle about the working blue-collar families. Well, we are thinking about the working blue-collar families. Why should they have to pay a little bit more in taxes? Why should they get less services when we're letting the richest of our society off the hook? This is something we absolutely must do. And there are always two arguments that are brought up about continuing the millionaire's tax. One, that it would hurt small business, and that is absolutely not the case. Did a lot of research on this issue before I introduced this amendment. I cannot find one study that shows small business would be affected by this, because remember, this is the personal income tax surcharge. The other argument that is always brought up is that the rich of the state of New York are going to leave. There have been numerous studies on this issue, and most independent studies have shown that people do not leave. And in fact, there was a 2011 New Jersey study, there was a 2011 New England study, which actually looked at 18 years of taxes in states throughout the country and found that tax rate do not influence mobility. And the one study that was done, which a lot of people refer to, the Partnership for New York City, actually did not look at people making $1 million or more. It merely looked at people who had wealth of $1 million or more. And finally, to counter that argument that people are leaving the state, this would affect 79,000 filers in the state of New York, and it would still account for $4.1 billion. That could go a long way to restore some of those services that we've had to cut. Of those 79,000 filers, 40,000 are New York State residents. 39,000 do not live in the state of New York. So anybody who says, we can't do this because people are going to leave, well, half of the filers already do not live in the state of New York, but they have to pay the income tax because of the amount of money they earn here. My colleagues, this is a fair thing to do. And I'm assuming the worst-case scenario that are going to be ruled out of order. This is not humane, but if that is the case, I ask the leadership to allow this issue to come up for a full debate. We owe that to the residents of this state, that we have a full debate on this issue so that both sides can get up and talk about it. Because I can tell you, whenever I go through my district, and I have some very wealthy middle-class neighborhoods, but I also have some working family neighborhoods. To a person, people say, why are we not taxing the 1% of income earners in this state? Why does the mayor of the city of New York threaten to close firehouses? Why are school districts throughout the entire state threatening to lay off teachers? This would stop that and only affect the top 1%, 79,000 filers. Only 40,000 live in the state of New York. And I think it was my colleague Susie Oppenheimer who said at a discussion on this that the people, the millionaires in her district, have said to her on a personal level, tax us. We're willing to pay the additional tax. So I urge my colleagues to vote for this amendment, and if I get ruled out of order, I ask the leadership to bring it up for a future consideration.